Hi everyone, Aaron here for zollotech, and yesterday Apple released macOS Catalina 10.15.4. This came out alongside iOS 13.4, iPadOS 13.4, and watchOS 6.2, all of which I've covered in separate videos. Now, this update brings new features and bug fixes and some updates, and so we'll talk about that in a moment, but the first thing is, this took quite a while to install. It took probably 30 minutes to install, and depending on your internet connection, that will vary a little bit. But let's take a look at the new features. So the first thing is, if we go into Finder and if we click on iCloud Drive, we now have iCloud Drive folder sharing. So if we right click or option click on a folder, we go to share, we now have an option to add people. So if we click on add people, we can now add people to collaborate within that folder so that they can actually download, maybe modify a file, and you can send that information to them through mail, messages, copy a link, or AirDrop. If we click on share options, you can change who can access it based on only people you invite or anyone with a link. Also, you can give them permissions to view only or make changes. So it's a nice little update that goes along with what we have on iOS 13.4. Let's go ahead and take a look at the next update, which has to do with screen time. So we'll close this out, we'll go to System Preferences, and then we'll go to Screen Time. Now under Screen Time, they've added a feature we've had for a little while on iOS. So if you set up family sharing and you have some children, you can select them here, and let me select another person. On the left, we have Communication. If we go into Communication, we now have communication limits for who your children can communicate with and be contacted by throughout the day and during downtime. So maybe they shouldn't be contacting someone while at school. You can turn that on. Otherwise, you can leave it open to everyone. It's just up to you as a parent. You could set this up for anyone though that you have in family sharing. Now they've also added additional controls to allow for access to things like music videos. So you can restrict access to it or allow it based off music profiles, or if we go into stores here, your TV shows, apps, and everything else. So the music videos have been added to this, and it's just something new that gives you a little extra control. Now they've updated music with the lyrics feature that we have already with iOS 13. So it's really nice. We'll wait for it to open here and go to For You. And if I click on a song here, I have my volume down, but I'll click play. And in the upper right, you'll see we have a lyrics button, and the lyrics are in real time, and we can click on any lyric to jump to that part in the song. So if I click down here, let me go ahead and click on this one. You'll see the song jumps up here. If I want to go back to the beginning of the song, it will jump back. So you can now have that within music on a Mac. So it's a really nice feature that we've had on iOS for a little while, but they've added to the Mac. And it works with any song that's in Apple Music that has lyrics. Not all of them have. Now there's some new updates within Safari or a couple extra features. So let's go into Safari. And if we go to File and then go down to Import From, we can select Google Chrome, and we now have the option to import passwords. So we can import any of those passwords into your iCloud keychain for an easy autofill of your information. So that will work across all of your devices. So that's really nice. Now they've also added controls for duplicating a tab and for closing all tabs to the right of the current tab. So we want to open this here, add a new one, click a little plus, and we can right click or option click and close tab or close other tabs. So we can close this tab. You've got a couple different options as well. So we can close them all at once. So we now have those options. And now Safari also supports HDR playback on compatible computers for Netflix content. So if you have an HDR display, you'll be able to see that. Now there's been some updates to the App Store, and the first one is universal purchase support. Now I mentioned this with my iOS 13.4 video, and what this allows for is maybe you purchase Affinity Designer. Well, the developer now has the option to give you that same app on your iPhone, iPod Touch, iPad, Mac, and Apple TV for one price. Now they don't have to do that, but there's that option now. So you've seen this a lot with iPhones and iPads, but now it carries across to the Mac. The other update is with Arcade. And if you subscribe to Arcade, you'll start seeing the options of games that will carry across different devices. So for example, if I try this new game Spider, I could start playing it here, and then I'll have the ability to continue playing that on an Apple TV, iPhone, iPod Touch, iPad, or Mac. So depending on what device I'm on, I can just continue it where I left off on the other devices. So it's a nice little update. Now there's an update with the new Pro Display XDR. So I don't have one of those. This is an iMac Pro I'm recording this on, but the Pro Display XDR, if we go to that, we'll go to Mac, and this is their $5,000 to $7,000 display, depending on which one you get, but they've added customized reference modes that you can tailor to specific workflow needs. So you can select things like color gamut and things like that. So if we go to displays, for example, we have our normal options, but we have different options for color gamut and things that will show up under color if you have a Pro Display XDR. There's a new accessibility option that's been added for controlling your Mac as well. So if we go into our preferences, then we go to accessibility, then we scroll down to pointer control. Under pointer control, if we click on alternate control methods, we now have enable head pointer. And this will allow the pointer to be controlled by your movement of your head captured by the camera, as it says here. So if I click on options, you can see there I am in the camera, and I can turn this on, and it's a little tricky to get it to use. But if I turn on head pointer, it says head pointer on, I should be able to control my pointer by looking at the screen using the control of my head, and you'll see the pointer is moving around. Now, it's not incredibly fluid on how to use it. It will take some time to learn how to use it, but the option is there if you want to use this. So it's nice that they're adding accessibility options for all sorts of controls. Now, the next update was a big one for me, or at least I thought so until I tried to use it, and that is display support for HDR10 compatible third-party displays. Now, Apple had only supported HDR on things like iMac Pro if you were watching specific movies, but now they're supporting it with third-party displays if you have an HDR10 compatible display. The catch is it only works over DisplayPort or HDMI for some reason. Now, I have a 5K by 2K display that I use with my Mac Pro, and you have to use HDMI or DisplayPort, but the Mac Pro only has HDMI, and the resolution is not correct when I'm doing that. Now, it looks good, but you don't have the options like you do here, such as scaled, where you can scale text and things like that, if you're not using the Thunderbolt connection. So hopefully Apple enables it to use Thunderbolt, but you do have a new option for HDR if you have an HDR10 compatible display and you're using those specific connectors. Now, they've added a couple things that are pretty quick to go over. OAuth authentication support with Outlook.com. They've also added CalDev migration support when upgrading to iCloud reminders on a secondary device. Now, they've resolved some issues where text copied between apps may appear invisible when dark mode is active. They've also fixed an issue in Safari where captcha tiles may not display correctly, and they've resolved issues with reminders not sending notifications for completed reminders. And then finally, they've fixed an issue with screen brightness on the LG Ultrafine 5K display after waking from sleep. So those are the bug fixes that they mentioned. And then there's also over 20 security updates that they've mentioned as well. And I can link those in the description so you can take a look at them, but they have to do with everything from the kernel to Bluetooth and other features as well. So a lot of things should be fixed in this update, and it should be more secure. That's it for macOS Catalina 10.15.4. If you've found anything else, let me know in the comments below, but really the big changes should come with the next version, with that live stream of WWDC or whatever happens with that. So expect 10.15.5 a little later on in June, at least a first look at it or sometime around then. But let me know if you found anything. If you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, I'll link it in the description as I always do. If you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.